In this video, we will learn how to set up and install pandas with PyCharm. So we'll be using PyCharm to run pandas program. Why? Because PyCharm provides a community version, a community edition, which is open source and freely available. These are the steps to install pandas with PyCharm. You need to remember that first you need to install NumPy also before installing pandas, because pandas is built on top of NumPy. Okay, at first you need to install Python and pip. Why pip? Because pip is a package manager. It is used to download, install and manage Python packages and library. So we'll be installing Python and pip first. Then we will install the PyCharm community edition, that is open source and freely available. Okay, then we will connect both Python and PyCharm, that is we will connect step 1 and step 2. After that, we will also learn how to run a first Python program on PyCharm. Okay, then we'll be installing NumPy because pandas need NumPy. After that, we'll be installing pandas. Both we will install on PyCharm so that we can run our first pandas program in the next chapter. Okay, so guys, let us start with the first step to install Python and pip. Let's start. At first, go to the web browser. On Google type Python and press enter. On pressing enter, the official website is visible. Click on it, python.org. Here is the official website. Now keep the mouse cursor on downloads. Now you can see the current version, Python 3.12.0, is visible. Click on it to download. It will download. It's only 25 MB. Download completed. Now right click and click on open to start installing Python. We clicked on the exe file, minimize. Now the setup started. Here and at first select add python.exe to path. Now click customize installation. This shows what we are installing. It will install pip also. Pip is used to download, install and manage Python packages. It will also install IDLE. IDLE is an ID to run Python programs. Now click next. Advanced option, it will install Python 3.12 for all users. It will also set the environment variables. Okay. And Python will get installed in the following location under program files. Keep it a default. You can change it from here by clicking browse. But keep it as it is. No problem. Click install. Now the installation started. Guys, we have successfully installed Python. Click close. Now let us verify the installation. Go to start, type cmd. Click open to open the command prompt. Herein type the command python space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. This shows that we successfully installed Python. Guys, we successfully installed the current Python version. Now we will install PyCharm. For that, go to the web browser. I am using Chrome. You can use any web browser. Here in type PyCharm and press enter. On pressing enter, the PyCharm is visible. It is owned by JetBrains. Click on it. Now we have reached the official website here. Now you can directly click download here, or you can also click download. Let's click. Herein you can see PyCharm Professional is visible, which is for a 30-day trial, then you need to pay. But we are going for the free version, that is the community. And here it is. You can download it from here. It is freely available and open source, so you can use it. EXE file download. Click on it. Now the download will begin. Here it is. The download started. It's only 418 MB. Let's wait. We have downloaded it. The EXE file for PyCharm. Community version, free version. Right click and click open to begin the installation. Minimize. The installation started. Click next. Now it is asking wherein PyCharm will get installed. It will get installed in the following location, keep it as it is, and it will take 1.5 GB. Click next. Desktop shortcut, yes, we can create. Update context menu, you can add a folder to project so that you can directly, so that you can open any folder as project. Rest keep as it is and click next. Start menu folder, yes, click install. And now the setup will begin. The desktop shortcut also got created. Now let's wait for this to complete. We have completed the PyCharm setup. I can also select Run PyCharm Community Edition and click Finish so that it begins. But I'll only click Finish. So in this way, we can install PyCharm. Now let us open PyCharm and connect Python with PyCharm. You can also go to Start and type PyCharm instead of going for the shortcut. Here it is, Community Edition, click Open. Now PyCharm will open for the first time. Here in the terms are visible, I confirm, click continue, data sharing. PyCharm opened for the first time. You can go to customize and here in select, let's say light theme or dark theme. I'll go for light theme and rest keep as it is. Go to projects, click new project. Herein you can see our project will get saved here. If you want to change the name of the project, you can change from here. Let's say I'll name it Amit Project. Okay. Now you need to set the environment. It will go for the virtual environment, a new environment, which is fine. The base interpreter you need to set. It is only showing Python 3.9 and 3.10. Click on the three dots. Program files, wherein we installed Python. 3.12, click on it. Select python.exe and click OK. Here it is, we have set Python 3.12 now. You can see we have set it. We have connected our Python with PyCharm. Okay, remove this because we are creating a sample program. Click Create. Okay, here is our project. I clicked here for the menus. Okay, now this is our project. This is our environment. Now we need to add a new Python file to run our first Python program. I'll right click on Amit project. Click new and herein select Python file directly. It will automatically go for .py extension. Herein add the name of your Python file and press enter. It will create demo.py. Here it is. Now you can directly run your first project. Let's say I'll just print something. Okay, I'll go for file, save all. Right click and click run demo. Here it is. Studio.pdf is visible. Okay, that means we successfully printed using the print method in Python. Here it is, Studio.pdf. You can also run using run here, click run demo, or you can use Shift F10 or Alt plus Shift plus F10. Okay, you can also increase the font by going to File, Settings. Here in Appearance is visible, go for Editor and click Font. Here in the font is only 13. Let me take it to 18 and click OK. Click Apply, then OK. Now the font will increase. Here it is. Even the output font is also 18 and the editor font also. With that, you can check the location also. Here it is. C users Amit underscore PyCharm projects. C users Amit underscore, that is the username. Here it is PyCharm project, projects Amit project. Here is a demo.py file. With that, you can also go to the file option and click settings. Okay, and select the project and the interpreter to verify again that you have set 3.12 or not for our project, and yes, we have set the same 3.12 for our project. We installed Python and PyCharm successfully, and we also ran a sample Python program. Now let us install pandas. I told you before that to install pandas we need NumPy. So first we will install NumPy, then we will install the pandas library. Let's start. To install NumPy, go to File, click Settings. After clicking Settings, you need to go to your project here. Okay, here is the project name, the same project. Click Python Interpreter. After clicking, click on the plus sign. Here and type NumPy. That's it. Here it is. This is the official website. Just select this and click Install Package. Now the installation will start. We have installed NumPy. Okay. Now type pandas. Here it is. Click Install Package and it will install pandas also. Click on it. Now pandas will get installed. We have also installed pandas. Click Close now. Now herein you can verify. We have installed both NumPy and pandas. That's it. Click OK. So guys, we successfully installed NumPy and pandas. Now we can start with our first pandas program. Thank you for watching the video.